Praise the Lord and greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is a broadcast of Apostolic Holiness Church of Jesus Christ located in Houston, Texas. Elder James Eugene Manuel is the pastor and general overseer. Prepare your hearts to receive a word from God as Elder James Eugene Manuel ministers the gospel of Jesus Christ.
You have to develop a prayer life, amen. And, you know, we don't have to sound extra sanctimonious or religious like some of these folk do. You know, they have like a little speech and all that. Amen. Praise God. You can talk to the Lord the same way that you talk to your, you know, praise God, everyday fellows. But it's because we respect, you know. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name. You know, just talk to the Lord. Say, Lord, I need your help. Lord, I want your help. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. In Jesus' name, Lord, I want to be saved. I want to be set free. I want to be totally free. And see, and that's the thing with the Lord. We can't be selective on, you know, what we want to be free from and what we want to hold on to. You know, you got some people with that kind of mindset. They say, well, yeah, I want to be delivered from this problem, but this here, I still like doing this, so I don't want to let this go. Amen. Praise the Lord. You can't do that with God.
No, you can't.
Now, you can do that in religion, you know, false religion and false teaching, you know, where they tell you, you just don't wallow. Amen. You know, people in there, amen, living any old kind of way, and, you know, amen. But now, when it comes to holiness, you have to let it all go. You got to be willing, amen, to let that old lifestyle go, amen, that old man, amen. You talking about the gossip and the, amen, innuendo, amen, and everything else that will keep you out of God's kingdom.
Right.
You know, not necessarily the habits that, you know, that's quite expensive nowadays. Amen. It's even getting more expensive by the year from the looks of it, particularly with the alcohol and tobacco. Amen. That's a, amen, very expensive and deadly habit. Amen. In Jesus' name. But, you know, you have to be willing to let it all go. Amen. Pornography. Amen. Cussing, lying, stealing, fornicating, whoremongering, adultery. Amen. You have to be willing, amen, to repent of all sin. Amen, in Jesus' name, and hallelujah. And you have that willing mind, amen. God, the Bible says that he's not willing that any of us should perish, but that we all come to repentance and be saved. So God wants us to be saved.
Yes, he does.
Amen, hallelujah. But you have to want to be saved too, meaning fully delivered. Mm-hmm. Amen, in Jesus' name. And I tell you, you got that mindset, and God is going to work on you.
Yes, he does.
Amen, because, hey, he worked on me. Amen. And he's no respectful person. He don't have favoritism. Amen. So he don't favor me over you, and he don't favor you over me.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. He loves us all the same.
Yes, he does.
Amen. Amen. There ain't no black church, no white church. Amen. No Hispanic church. Amen. When it comes to God. Amen. Praise God. It's a church that one has to be born into. Amen. Either in it or not. Amen. So you know that prejudice and racism is not of God.
No, it's not.
Amen. In Jesus' name. So, amen. Person can't be saved and they have prejudice. Amen. Mm-hmm. Take it right now. You got a problem with someone of a certain race, you need to pray and ask God to deliver you, amen, from that hatred. Amen. Or that prejudice. Amen. Because it's bad people in every race.
Yes, it is.
Amen. So we know it's bad people in our race.
Yep.
Amen. A whole bunch of bad folk. Amen. Make some of us decent folk look bad. Amen. Praise God. All you have to do is turn on the news or turn on social media. Amen. You see Negroes acting up. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. All the time. Amen. So, but it's bad people in all races, just like it's good people in all races. Amen. So God, you know, didn't make us to be, you know, separate from one another. He made all races and creeds and colors and languages, you know, so it can be like a type of a flower garden. Amen. And you look, just think about a flower garden. You have posies and daisies and roses and
tulips.
And tulips, amen, and lilies.
Yeah.
Amen. Sunflowers, amen. Yeah. And it all looks beautiful, amen.
Beautiful.
Praise God. So that's the same way that God looks at us. Amen. All races. That's the way that we should look at them. Amen. Praise God. All unique. Amen. We come together and just look like a flower, Lord.
Yes.
Amen. In Jesus' name. So we thank God. Amen. For all things. Amen. So just keep seeking the Lord. Amen. You may have to get to praying more.
Yeah.
Now you may have to get to fasting, because I did a lot of fasting. Amen. For
sure
deliverance. Amen. And we ain't talking about bread or water, and, you know, like these ministries say, you know, fruit and vegetable fast, you know, a fish and bread fast. That ain't a fast if you're still eating and drinking. I'll tell you that right now. Amen. A fast is when you're neither eating anything nor drinking anything. Amen. And so, you know, because the word of God says, amen, that's the only way that some pattern is going to be broken.
Yeah.
Amen. Of course, you know, you're going to have to do some resisting the devil yourself, but yeah, it's going to come a point in time, amen, if you're really serious with God, you're going to drop that.
But point. When you're taking medicine, you...
Oh, yeah. I understand when you're taking medicine, you have to kind of, you know, kind of be a little careful
eat.
And, yeah, but now, I ain't saying don't take your medicine and things like that. No, you won't hear me say that, amen, in Jesus' name, but the Lord will give you wisdom.
Oh, yeah.
You know, where you can still consecrate and as well as seek his face, you know, for what you need. Amen, in Jesus' name. So we thank God for what he has done. We thank God for the gospel of Jesus Christ, the death, burial, and resurrection. Amen, because Jesus Christ, he didn't have to put on flesh and blood, amen, and die on the cross for us. Amen. That was God in that man. Amen. The Spirit of God was in the man Christ Jesus. Like the Bible says, he was reconciling the world unto himself. Amen. That's why he was able to do things that no other man did before or even after he left. Amen. What man was able to walk on water? Amen. Walk on the water. Amen. What other man was able to, amen, praise God, just rise up in a cloud and go back to heaven where he came from? Amen. No other man did that. Amen. Praise God. Now, we know Elijah was translated in the Old Testament. Amen. He didn't die a natural death. Amen. He was carried up by the chariots of fire. Amen. But out of the cloud. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. So we know that Jesus Christ, he was more than just an ordinary man. He was more than just a prophet. Amen. He was the Almighty God manifested in flesh. Amen. Because the Bible says that, amen, without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world, and received up into glory. That's 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. Amen. In Jesus' name. So, praise the Lord and good morning for those of you who are tuning in through the live stream or the archive message. This is the Apostolic Holiness Church of Jesus Christ. We are located at 4204 Highway 6 North, Houston, Texas, 77084. Amen. And the current schedule is Sundays at 10 a.m. We are located inside the conference room of the Bear Creek Inn. Amen. And you can give us a call at 832-360-5812. And you can also go to our web address. That's ahcjc.com. Amen. And currently, the schedule is Sundays at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. Amen. So if you're in or near the Houston area, you're more than welcome to, amen, fellowship with us. Amen. And so we thank God for everyone who pressed their way.
Yes.
Amen. In Jesus' name, and those who wanted to come and, amen, couldn't make it or wouldn't make it, the Lord knows. And those who are tuning in through the live stream, because we have an internet audience. Amen. People watching. Amen. People are watching.
That's good.
Yes, indeed. Amen. Thank God he bring me through these afflictions. Amen. Amen. I got my voice back for the most part.
Amen.
But I lost it. Yes, indeed. But afflictions come and go, but God remains the same. Lord will, we won't be up here too long. Let's see here. Let's go into the book of, start off in the book of Matthew, chapter 11. Amen. Because Jesus, he came to give us rest. Amen. Rest from sin. Amen. Rest from worry. Amen. Rest from anxiety. Amen. Rest from fear. Rest from doubt. Amen. Rest from unbelief. Amen. Rest from living in sin. Amen. So Jesus Christ, amen, he is, amen, the rest giver. So Matthew chapter 11. And we'll begin at verse 25. So anyone get to Matthew chapter 11, verse 25? Say amen. That's the first book in Matthew chapter 11 of the Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Amen.
So Matthew chapter 11, and we'll begin at verse 25. At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Amen. And that's what's going on today. Amen. Mm-hmm. Praise God. God, you know, he reveals, amen, the simplicity of the gospel, the simplicity of the apostles' doctrine, amen, to those who will humble themselves. So that's, amen, what the meaning is when it says, reveal them unto babes. He hid these things from the wise and prudent. So, you know, the false prophet that then went to a seminary or a cemetery, amen, you know, people call it a seminary, mm-hmm. amen, when he went to a so-called Bible school, amen, now he got a piece of paper, and now he's a certified false prophet, mm-hmm. amen, that's all that is, amen, a school, amen, a cemetery, where the dead are teaching the dead, mm-hmm. so they can become a certified false prophet, amen, even though they don't say certified false prophet, I'm saying it because it's the truth. Amen. They said, well, I got my DD degree in the doctrine of divinity and this and that, school of theology, blah, blah, blah. Amen. You ain't nothing but a certified false prophet. Amen. That piece of paper don't mean nothing because the true man of God, amen, he ain't going to go to school, amen, to be taught by an unsaved man, amen, how to be a saved man of God. Amen. That's just totally backwards. Amen. So I thank God I didn't went to no amen. Seminary. Amen. Amen. They teaching all kind of myths. Amen. A lot of those guys, they go in them seminaries. Amen. They come out of them seminaries turned out. Mm-hmm. Amen. Don't even believe the Bible no more. Amen. Don't even believe in God anymore. Amen. You'd be surprised. Amen. Now they just look at it as a career. Amen. Come out there and say, hey, let me start this plan so I can see, you know, what I'm going to do to get rich. And that's what they do, amen, because they don't believe God, amen, but they look at it as a good, amen, career, amen, a good line of field where they can, you know, support their family and have people, amen, bring in tithes and offerings, amen, which the, amen, New Testament don't have no commandment, amen, to give or receive, amen, so it's about money, but amen, I thank God I didn't went to no, amen, dead school. So we read that verse again. At that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent. Amen. And most of these preachers, amen, they don't preach no Acts 2:38 that you have to repent, amen, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and amen, that you need to be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost and live a holy life. Now, they'll tell you, bow your head and repeat after me the sinner's prayer. Amen. You talk about Acts 2:38, they don't understand that. Oh, well, that ain't for us today. Amen. So it is hid from them. Amen. But he said, and has revealed them unto babes. Amen. And in another scripture, you can say that we have to humble ourselves and become as a little child.
Yeah.
Amen. Otherwise, we're not going to enter into the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
Amen. So part of, amen, coming to the Lord Jesus Christ is humility. Amen. You have to humble yourself. Amen. I had to humble myself. Amen. Praise God. Thought I knew some things. Amen. Once I came to holiness, amen, I realized I ain't do too much of nothing. Amen. I knew how to quote some scriptures, but amen, that don't mean nothing. You don't understand what them scriptures mean. Yes, indeed. Yeah, so. And then he says, verse 26, even so, Father, for it seemed good in thy sight, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whom the Son will reveal him. Okay, so you can hold your place there in Matthew 11, 27. And let's go to the Gospel according to St. John. John chapter 12. Let's make sure we're still alive. All right, praise the Lord, we're still alive. So John chapter 12. So hold your place in Matthew 11, 27. And let's go to John chapter 12. We're going to find out, we're going to find out who the Father is. For those of us who don't yet know who the Father is, amen, we're about to go to the scripture. So that way, you realize, amen, that Jesus wasn't referring to a second person or the first person of the Godhead. You know, the person read Matthew 11, 27, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal. You know, they'll think, well, he's talking to two different people. You know, okay, the Father and the Son, that's two different persons. Amen. But let's go to John chapter 12. John chapter 12 and verse 44. So John chapter 12, verse 44, Jesus cried and said, and when you get there, you say amen.
Amen.
John chapter 12, verse 44. So John chapter 12, verse 44, Jesus cried means that he yelled, amen. He not that he, crying and weeping and wailing, amen. Means that he elevated his voice. Jesus cried and said, he that believeth on me, believeth not on me, but on him that sent me. He knows that the Father said. Mm-hmm. Amen. And then he goes so further to say, verse 45, and he that seeth, in other words, looking at, in other words, he say, and he that's looking at me, or he that seeth me, seeth him that sent me. Amen. So, what does that tell you?
They all one.
Jesus is the Father.
They all one.
Amen. They all one. Yes, indeed. Amen. So, when he said, amen, Matthew 11, 27, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father, save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him, amen, he was just talking about one person, amen, one being. He was talking about himself, because Jesus is the Father, amen. But why would he say, amen, he that believeth on me, believeth not on me, but on him that sent me? And he that seeth me, see of him that sent me. Amen. He said, if you're looking at me, you're looking at the one who sent me. Amen. So Jesus sent himself into this world, amen, as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth, as the Lamb of God, amen, in order to shed his blood on the cross at Calvary to take away the sins of the world. Amen. Could no one else send God into this world but God? Amen. Praise God. Because he has that power. Amen. If he made the heavens and the earth, amen, and made everything in it, amen, made angels, made man, amen, after his image and likeness, amen, should we think that it was a hard thing for God to make himself a flesh and blood body? Amen. And then, of course, that flesh and blood body that he made for himself, he called it his son.
That's right.
Amen. That's exactly what God did. Amen. And that's exactly who Jesus is. Jesus is God. Amen. He's not just the son. Amen. He's also the father. Amen. And Jesus is also the Holy Ghost. Amen. That's why, amen, we reject that Trinitarian garbage, amen, that was started up by the Roman Catholic Church, started up by slave masters. Amen. Same people that was whipping our ancestors, amen, on the plantation fields, amen, had us chopping trees and picking cotton, amen, just dogging our people out, amen, treating us like animals, amen. Amen. That's their doctrine. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. It didn't start in Jerusalem. Amen. The Trinitarian teaching didn't start in Jerusalem. Amen. It started in Rome. Amen. Around the end of the 3rd century. Mm-hmm. Amen. 4th century. Amen. And then, of course, around, I guess, a little after the Dark Ages ended, you know, a lot of the churches. Groups split away from the Catholic Church because they felt that the Catholic Church was just too bad or too corrupt. And so they started the Protestant Reformation or the Protestant movement. Amen. So they were no longer, you know, doing the Hail Mary and the rosary beads and, you know, going to an unsaved man, calling him father and, you know, going into a confessional booth. Amen. But they still held on to that Trinitarian teaching. You know, it's three gods in heaven. Amen, and everything else, amen. And so they were teaching, amen, their children, and of course they were teaching them slaves, amen. Our ancestors, amen, that Trinitarian doctrine. That's why so many of our people are Baptists, amen, because of what they received from their forefathers, and their forefathers received from their slave masters, amen. That's slave master teaching, amen. If you're going to be something, don't be Baptist. Amen. You either be holy or don't be nothing at all. Amen. I don't want to follow something that some slave master then brought up. Amen. Praise God. But, you know, you tell some people this, they get fighting back with you. Mm-hmm. Amen. Just read your history. Amen. They got books about this. Amen. Who started up the Baptist religion? Who started up, amen, the Colgate religion? Who started up Presbyterianism and Episcopalian and Seventh-day Adventist? It was all started up by some unsaved man trying to establish his own righteousness. Amen. And so we thank God for truth because the truth will make you free. Amen.
Sure will.
Praise God. Amen. Of course, all of us in here grew up Baptist. Yeah. Amen. Before we even realized why we was in the Baptist church. Amen. Praise God. We were just in it like Bennett. Didn't have a clue. Amen. Praise God. But we serve a true God that's not willing, amen, that we should be ignorant. God don't want us to be ignorant of these things. Amen. So praise God. And he don't want us to be ignorant of who he really is. Amen. Jesus Christ is the very God, amen, of all creation. Amen. That's why we sing the song. Yeah, so we read that again. Amen. John chapter 12, verse 44 to 45. Jesus cried and said, he that believeth on me, believeth not on me, but on him that sent me. And he that seeth me, seeth him that sent me. Amen. Jesus Christ is the Father. He sent himself. Amen. Because he is, amen, the very God. That's why Thomas, amen, confessed John chapter 20, verse 28. Thomas said, my Lord and my God. Amen. We call him Doubting Thomas because, you know, he was like, hey, man, if I don't see Jesus for myself, and if I don't put my fingers in the nail print in his hand and on his side, I'm not going to believe. I don't care what y'all say. Amen. And then Jesus appeared unto him. Amen. And to the disciples. Amen. And where they were hiding at. And then he said, look here, Thomas. Look at my hands and my side. You know, don't be doubting. Amen. But believe. And then that's when Thomas said in John chapter 20, verse 28, my Lord and my God. Amen. Because that's who Jesus is. He's our Lord and our God. Amen. So now we can go back to Matthew 11, 27. Matthew chapter 11, verse 27. So now we understand what he means when he says, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, And no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father, save the Son. And he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Amen. Because they are one. Jesus Christ is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Amen. He revealed himself, amen, in those three ways or three manifestations, as some call it, but not doesn't make him three separate persons. Amen. Just like us, we have a body, a soul, and a spirit. Amen. Because that's the way that God made us. But we're not three separate people. Amen. I mean, do you see three different people in me? Do you see James the soul, and James the spirit, and James the body? Amen. No, you just see one person, James. And the same thing with you. You don't got three personalities, do you? No. Amen. So neither should we think that God has three separate personalities. Amen. Like he got some mental issues. Amen. But that's what, amen, the false church will tell you. Amen. Tell you Trinitarian. They tell you Trinity. And Trinity means three separate people, three separate personalities, three separate entities. Amen. And that's just a straight up lie, amen, from the devil himself. Amen. But I tell you, that's why Jesus said, amen, early on in this chapter here, verse 25. Amen. Matthew 11, verse 25. He said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things. Amen. The simplicity of the oneness of God. Hear these things from the wise and prudent. They have all that education, all that knowledge, but yet they don't understand, amen, that there is only one God. Mm. There is no Trinity. Amen. But they got all this learning. Amen. It's like the Bible says, ever learning, but never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Amen. All that book. I'd rather just be, amen, praise God. I'd rather just be dumb and know the truth of who Jesus is than have all that education. Amen. On my way to the lake of fire. Amen. Because it's all in vain. And that's what's going to keep a lot of people out of heaven. That pride. Amen. They look at, well, I got two or three college degrees. You know, I'm twice your age. You can't tell me nothing. Amen. Because they have that pride. They have that arrogance. You know, they look at you as, you know, being below them. Amen. So, you know, and of course, in my case, they would consider me to be an ignorant and an unlearned man. See, I didn't went to a cemetery, and I don't got a dumb dog degree. Amen. Praise God. I'm just a man who just humbled himself and, you know, sat under the feet of Jesus. Amen. And, you know, and waited on the Lord to give me revelation and the knowledge of the truth. Amen. Praise God. And at the appointed time, he sent me to preach the word. Amen. I ain't went to no dead school. Amen. So they'll be asking me, where's my credentials? Amen. Well, my credentials is in heaven. Amen. I don't need a piece of paper to validate, amen, what God put in me. Amen. Yeah. So that's been hidden from the so-called wise and prudent and has revealed among the suckling babes. So now let's go to verse 28. Jesus said, Matthew chapter 11, verse 28, come unto me. So now Jesus is asking them all to come to him. Amen. Say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Amen. So everybody that's labored and heavy laden, amen, and I will give you rest. And sin is a type of labor, amen, and heavy laden. Amen. Because sin is hard work. Amen. And just look at what sin is doing to people. Amen. It's tearing them down. It's slowly killing them, amen. You hear on the news all the time, people die, amen, overdosing on drugs, amen. That's the result of sin, amen. OD on crack, or OD on heroin, OD on something, amen. Praise God. Now, had they just came to Jesus and, amen, allowed Jesus to give them rest, amen, they've been alive today, amen. Serve the Lord and been happy, but you know, the sad part about it is most of the world don't want Jesus. Amen. They don't want the Jesus that, you know, loves them, but at the same time requires holiness. Amen. They want that Jesus that say, oh, it's all right, brother. Just do the best you can. I know you can't help it. You don't have to stop sinning. Mm. You just keep on doing what you're doing, and I love you anyway. Mm. Amen. And I bring you into the kingdom, amen, once you die. Amen. Amen. But that's nowhere in the Bible. Amen. I could see if there was a specific scripture that says that you can live just as wicked as you want, and at the end of the day, amen, you're going to be saved. No, it's not in the Holy Bible. It's probably some made-up book that man writes today. Amen. But it's not in the Holy Bible. Amen. It say Holy Bible. It don't say do the best you can by it. Amen. Just think about that. Yeah, but you know, these so-called preachers, amen, they preach like it's a do the best you can Bible, you know. Amen. God know you can't help it Bible. No. Amen. Praise God. Amen. But God loves you. Amen. God loves me. God loves everybody, but he hates sin. Amen. And you want to know that God loves you. Amen. Praise God. Just think about all the times that he could have took you out.
That's right.
Amen. That you had your brush with death. I know I had my brush with death.
Amen.
Amen. A few brushes. Praise God. Hallelujah. But God, amen, kept me alive. Amen. I was in sin, wasn't ready to die. Amen. Hallelujah. But God kept us, amen, by his grace and his mercy, because he don't want you to die in your sins and go to hell. Amen. But people that do, amen, they do so because it's their choice. Amen. Folk are going to hell and going to be eternally lost because of the choices they make. Amen. They make the conscious decision and say, well, you know, I don't want to serve the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Yeah, I want to go to heaven, but I don't want to live right. And, you know, and basically that's, you know, Jesus, he's like the, he's a perfect gentleman. He ain't going to make us do right. You know, he wants us to do right. He ain't going to make us do right. Amen. And at the end of the day, amen, everyone shall be rewarded according to their own works.
That's right.
Amen. So Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Amen. You come to Jesus, amen, with your burden of sin, say, Lord, I want this off me. Amen. That should be your prayer. Lord, take this away from me. Take the desire away from me. Amen. Take the desire away from me. I don't even want to be around it. Don't want to see it. Amen. Don't want it in my life. Amen. Want to be totally set free, totally delivered. Want to be resting in you. Amen. I tell you, Jesus will give you that rest. He will give you a rest. He wants to give you that rest. Amen. And then he says, take my yoke upon you, verse 29. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you can learn of Jesus Christ, of course, by reading his word. Amen. Say, learn of me. Amen. Learn how he reacts to things. Amen. Learn how he talks to people. Amen. Learn how you're supposed to treat, amen, your neighbor. Amen. How you're supposed to treat your enemy. Amen. How you're supposed to treat your family. Amen. For I am meek. And meek it means gentle. And lowly in heart. And ye shall find rest unto your souls. So now we know this isn't just a natural type of rest. This is a spiritual rest. He say rest unto your soul, amen, not to your body, amen, because, you know, we still in this world, amen, we still have to work on these natural jobs for those of us who are working, amen, but he talking about spiritual rest, amen, rest for your soul, amen. And then he says, for my yoke is easy, and my burden is light, amen. So you should want the yoke and burden of Jesus Christ that he gives you, because he's going to give you an easy yoke and a light burden. Amen. It's not going to be, amen, as verse 28 says, amen, heavy laden. Amen. It's not going to be a laboring, heavy laden. Amen. When your health is constantly declining, amen, because of the lifestyle that you live. Amen. Jesus, amen, wants to give you rest from that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Because when you get the rest that Jesus wants to give you, amen, praise God, you'll find that you'll be saving more money. Amen. Because you'll be spending less money. Amen. Because sin is very expensive. Amen. Especially depending on what type of sin you're into. Amen. Praise God. You'll be able to hold money in your pocket. Amen. Your health will improve. Have more energy. Praise God. Be able to give God the praise more. Amen. In Jesus' name, in verse 30, he said, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Amen. And now let's go into Acts chapter 2. I know we go here a lot, but amen, this is the salvation message. Amen. So this was after the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. After he, amen, died on the cross and shed his blood. Amen. Was buried. Amen. In that tomb for 3 days and 3 nights. Amen. And after he rose again from the dead. Amen. He, amen, gave his disciples, amen, admonishment, and then he went back up, amen, to heaven, where he came from. That's why John the Baptist had said that he that coming from above is above all. That's John chapter 3. He said, he that coming from above is above all. Amen. He said, he that coming from heaven is above all. And so on the day of Pentecost in Acts chapter 2, amen, we'll start at verse 1. It says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, Acts chapter 2, verse 1, they were all with one accord in one place. They were in that upper room. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. So before this happened, amen, Jesus had told them, amen, in chapter 1, that to wait and tarry at Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high, till you receive that promise of the Father. So now, amen, chapter 2, they're getting ready to receive the promise of the Father, even the gift of the Holy Ghost. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it set upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Amen. So they were filled with the Holy Ghost, and that's how they knew they had it. Amen. They spoke in other tongues as the Spirit, or the capital S. Spirit gave them utterance. Amen. Not as someone makes it up on their own, and, you know, mumble some stuff. Amen. But they don't have no power. Amen. Praise God. These people here on the day of Pentecost, they received some power. Amen. Not only they spoke in tongues, amen, but they had the power, amen, to live right. Amen. The power to do right. Amen. So I'm not really impressed when someone speaks in tongues and they live contrary. Amen. Because you see that all the time. Amen. In Jesus' name. You want the Holy Ghost power. Amen. Power to keep you from sin. Amen. Not just speaking in a tongue, but to keep you living holy. Amen. To keep you resisting the devil. Amen. Resisting that temptation when it comes your way. Amen. The power to say no to sin. Amen. Hallelujah. To give you joy in the time of sorrow. Hallelujah. That's the Holy Ghost power there. Amen. And then it says, and there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded. Verse 6, Acts chapter 2. Now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because that every man heard him speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all these which be Galileans? So they knew that they were from Galilee. And then it says, and how hear we every man in our own tongue? In other words, language. Wherein we were born. Parthians and Medes and Elamites and the dwellers of Mesopotamia and in Judea and Cappadocia and Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia and Egypt, and in the parts of Libya about Cyrene, that's Africa. Amen. Cyrene was an African country. Amen. And strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and were in doubt, saying one to another, what meaneth this? Others mocking, saying, these men are full of new wine. Amen. So the devil was, amen, also on the scene, amen, mocking what was going on. Saying, oh man, they really drunk. They full of that new wine. Amen. But verse 14, but Peter, so Peter, amen, was a true apostle. Amen. Who God handpicked, amen, and sent. Amen. And then, of course, we know that Peter denied Jesus 3 times. Amen. Before, you know, the crucifixion. Amen. And he even told Peter, he said, you know, verily I say unto you, Peter, Amen. Before this, amen, rooster crow twice, you're going to deny me three times. Amen. But of course, the King James Version, amen, it don't say rooster, it say cock. Amen. Mm-hmm. That's the archaic word for a rooster today.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He said, before the cock crow twice, you shall deny me twice. Or in other words, three times. And that's exactly what Peter did. Amen. But hallelujah, he repented. Amen. Amen, in Jesus' name. So he ain't denying Jesus no more. Amen. So, verse 14, but Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. And then now he's, amen, making a point here. For these are not drunken. Man, he's saying they ain't drunk. They ain't full of no new wine. But these are not drunken, as ye suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. Amen. Which is around 9 o'clock. Amen. People don't get drunk at 9 o'clock in the morning. Amen. On average. At least not back then. Of course, you got some alcoholics now. Amen. But back then, amen, people didn't get drunk at 9 in the morning. Amen. Because the first hour, amen, starts at 6 o'clock. So, amen. So this was actually around 9 o'clock in the morning, amen, on the day of Pentecost when they were filled with the Holy Ghost and spoke with other tongues. Amen. So Peter let them know, nah, they ain't drunk. Amen. It's just 9 o'clock. But he says, but this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel, and it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Amen. So hallelujah. I exhort you to call on the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Especially when you pray. Amen. You always want to end your prayer, amen, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Don't pray, amen, without ending your prayer, amen, or praying in the name of Jesus Christ. Or Lord Jesus, amen. Praise God. Because he said, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Now, people take that scripture and run to Timbuktu and Hoboken and back. Amen. Oh, man, he said, I ask anything in his name, he going to do it. God. He said that, but then you got to read on further. Amen. In 1 John, where it says, if you ask anything according to his will, according to God's will, he hears you. Amen. And then if you know that he hears you, matter of fact, we go there. So you can hold your place here in Acts 2 and 22. And go to 1 John. John chapter 5. So not the gospel according to St. John, but the first epistle for St. John is kind of close to Revelation, before we get to Revelation. So 1 John chapter 5. So after the Peters. So 1 John chapter 5 and verse 14. You hear someone say, oh, she said, if you ask anything in my name, I'll do it. I want to win the lottery. They're asking all kinds of mess, you know? And read on. So 1 John chapter 5, first, is right, yeah, first epistle of St. John is right before chapter 5, 1 John chapter 5. And verse 14. Now you get that clarification of what it means. It says, okay. So 1 John chapter 5, verse 14, and it says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, amen. So not according to our will, amen, winning the lottery, or, you know, Lord bless me with a girlfriend, bless me with a boyfriend, amen. You had a homosexual, amen, asking him for a homosexual partner, amen. They just read that scripture in the gospel, amen. Oh, you say I ask anything in his name, you do it. No. Read 1 John 5 and 14. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, amen. So according to God's desire, according to what he wants you to have, amen. If we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. So if you ask anything that Jesus wants you to have, amen, then rest assured that he is listening to you. It doesn't matter what kind of state or condition that you're in. If you ask God for something that he wants you to have, he hears you. So, for example, if you ask God for deliverance, he's listening. Amen. If you asking God, amen, to break the yokes in your life, he's listening. Amen. If you asking God to deliver you from a habit, amen, that you bound under, God is listening. Amen. So that's what this scripture means. If we ask anything according to his will, because God wants you to be saved, God wants you to be delivered, God wants you to be blessed. Amen. And then the Bible says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. Amen. That's Psalms chapter 1. We just quote that. Amen. But you can go there on your own time and read the entire chapter of Psalms 1. Amen. So it says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. Amen. So God is listening. In verse 15, and if we know that he hears us, so now if you know that God is listening to you when you ask him for something that he wants you to have, amen, God wants you to be saved, he wants you to be sanctified, he wants you to be full of the Holy Ghost, you can ask God for that. And believe me, amen, when I tell you, he will be listening to you, amen. That's the prayer that God hears. Amen. And if we know that he hears us, so now if you know that he's listening now, amen, you asking God for something that he wants you to have according to his will, or according to the will of God, according to the will of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is God. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, amen. Lord, I need these bills paid. Amen. According to his will, amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. He'll see to it, amen, that the bill is paid.
That's right.
Amen. And he'll see to it, amen, that you get deliverance. Amen. Because God wants you to be delivered. Amen. And if, let's see here. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions. Amen. In other words, requests. That's what petition means, request. We know that we have the petition that we desire to do. Amen. It has to be something that God wants you to have. Amen. So if you're asking God for something that he wants you to have, you're going to get it. You're going to receive it. He's going to give it to you. Amen. In Jesus' name. So, amen. So, hallelujah. So that's contrary to what the false prophet will tell you. Yeah, same thing you think you do. Win low. Go on the gambling boat. No. Amen. That's straight up lie from the devil. Amen. God ain't gonna bless you with no lottery. Amen. That's the devil work. Amen. That's blood money. Amen. But you got some people, they mind so messed up. They, God bless me, win lottery. And yet God of this world, lowercase g, the prince of darkness, that's who bless you to win that lottery. Amen. Because that's his game. Amen. So let's go back to Acts chapter 2. Amen. Hope you held your place there. Amen. I believe we stopped at verse 22. So Acts chapter 2, verse 22. This apostle Peter, he's preaching, amen, on the day of Pentecost, amen. He just received the Holy Ghost, amen. Some, amen, these so-called preachers, they don't have, amen. Because if they had the Holy Ghost, they'd preach the same thing that Peter preached. He said, ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourselves also know, verse 23, Acts chapter 2, him being delivered by the determinate counsel and foreknowledge of God, ye have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain, whom God have raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be holding of it. For David speaketh concerning him, I foresaw the Lord always before my face, for he is on my right hand, that I should not be moved. Therefore did my heart rejoice and my tongue was glad. Moreover also my flesh shall rest in hope, because thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither wilt thou suffer thine Holy One to see corruption. Thou hast made known unto me the ways of life. Thou shalt make me full of joy with thy countenance. Men and brethren, let me freely speak unto you of the patriarch David, that he is both dead and buried, and his sepulchre is with us unto this day. Therefore, being a prophet, and knowing that God has sworn with an oath to him, that of the fruit of his loins, according to the flesh, he will raise up Christ to sit on his throne. He, seeing this before, spake of the resurrection of Christ, or the resurrection of Jesus, that his soul, or the soul of Jesus, Jesus' soul, was not left in hell. So, if it was not left in hell, that means that it had to been there. Amen. Because Jesus went to hell. Amen. His body was buried in that tomb because he was God Almighty. At the same time, he was able to tell that repentant thief on the cross, verily I say unto you, today you shall be with me in paradise. Amen. That's what he told the thief. He said, you're going to be with me today in paradise. Because Jesus, he's still God. Right. Amen. He still was in heaven, even though his body was on the cross dying. Amen. For the sins of the world. But he was also a man. So, and he, since he put upon himself the sins of the world, he died as a sinner. Right. And where do sinners go? They souls go to hell. Just like that rich man in Luke chapter 16. Amen. He lived a big time lifestyle. Amen. And Bible say, you know, he was the rich man died and was buried, and in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torments. Amen. But that beggar Lazarus, amen, that was laid at his gate full of sores, amen. Lazarus died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom, meaning that his soul was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. Amen. But his body was dead. So now we see that Jesus, amen, we know his body was in that tomb for 3 days and 3 nights, but his soul went to hell. Because he died as a sinner in our place. So we don't have to die as a sinner. Right. Amen. That was the purpose, amen, of Jesus Christ, amen, becoming the sacrifice for us. So we don't have to die as a sinner. Amen. That we can give our lives to God, amen, while we can, amen, in the land of the living. Amen. And repent of our sins. Amen. That's our type of death. Amen. Repentance. Amen. And it's a willful thing because Jesus willingly died. Amen. We have to willingly repent. Amen. Willingly turn from sin. So, we still in Acts 2. Verse 31. He seeing this before, spake of the resurrection of Christ, that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh or his body did see corruption. So his body didn't rot. It wasn't rotten or decaying. It wasn't stinking. This Jesus Jesus have God raised up. Well, we're all witnesses. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he has shed forth this which ye now see and hear. For David is not ascended into the heavens, but he saith of himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou on my right hand, until I make thy foes thy footstool. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made that same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Amen. He let them know Jesus is both Lord and he's Christ. Amen. And the Bible says, know ye that the Lord, he is God. Amen. So he's saying he's both the Lord God and he's the Messiah. And so verse 37, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts. So now they felt conviction. Amen. They felt some regret. Amen. To have them, a lot of those people on the day of Pentecost, they were the same ones that was, amen, that turned on Jesus. They crucified him. Amen. Give us Barabbas. Mm. Now they on the day of Pentecost, amen, heard Peter full of the Holy Ghost preaching the truth. Amen. Now they feel some conviction. Mm. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Amen. They want to know what can they do to be right. Amen. And then verse 38, then Peter said unto them, repent. Amen. In other words, turn from your sinful ways and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So after you repent, amen, you have to be baptized in water, mm-hmm, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Some might say, I was baptized when I was 5 or 6 or 10 in the Baptist church. Amen. That baptism wasn't nothing. That was a waste of time. You got wet for nothing. Amen. Because all he did was just repeated the titles. Like, now I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Never used the name. Amen. He used them titles on you. Amen. Amen. Because the name of the Father is Jesus. John chapter 5, verse 43 will tell you that. Jesus said, I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. Mm-hmm. So the name of the Father is Jesus. Of course, hey, I don't think no one going to argue with me about the name of the Son being Jesus. Mm-hmm. But Matthew 1:21 confirms that as well. Amen. That she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. And the name of the Holy Ghost is Jesus. John chapter 14, verse 26. But the Comforter, who is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. So Apostle Peter, being full of the Holy Ghost, told them how they should be baptized. Keep in mind, he was a true apostle. Amen. You got a lot of these guys nowadays call themselves apostles. Amen. But they don't have the power. Mm-hmm. Amen. They just got a name and a title and a whole bunch of talk. Amen. And don't even preach the same thing that Apostle Peter did on the day of Pentecost, preaching a totally different gospel. Amen. So verse 38, that's why Peter, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Amen. So it's a promise that God has made. Amen. For you, amen. For your children and to everyone as a far off. Amen. So your children can be saved, you can be saved. Amen. Grandchildren can be saved. Praise God. Everybody can be saved. You just have to obey the scriptures. Amen. You have to obey what the word says. You have to obey the gospel. And then verse 40. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Amen. You have to save yourself. Amen. Praise God. You can pray for someone else and amen and hope they make the right choice for themselves, but they have to save themselves if they want to be saved. Amen. And the only way that you can save yourself is by obeying, amen, the gospel. Amen. Obeying Acts 2:38. Amen. Praise God. You believe that Jesus Christ died and was buried and rose again, amen, you likewise have to die, be buried, and rise again. So that's what Acts chapter 2, verse 38 is all about. Our death, our burial, and our resurrection. So our type of death is when we repent of our sins. Amen. When we turn away from the practice of our evil ways. Amen. That's the type of death. Because when you die, amen, you don't get back up and get back to it. Amen. When a person is dead in that casket, amen, they could have been the biggest crackhead in the state of Texas. Amen. You can, praise God, give them a, amen, a big old bag of crack. Amen. They ain't gonna smoke. Because they dead. They in the casket. Amen. Same thing. Amen. If they was a weed head, they could have been the biggest pothead, amen, in the country. Amen. They die, they dead, they in that casket, amen. Put a pound of weed in the casket, amen. They will not get to smoke. So they dead. So that's the same thing with us. Amen. The Bible says, reckon yourselves likewise to be dead indeed unto sin. Amen. And alive unto God. Amen. So we supposed to be dead to sin, but alive unto God. Alive, amen, to live holy, alive to live right. Amen. So repentance is our type of death to sin. Amen. And water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, that's our type of death, of burial. Amen. We're buried with him by water baptism. Amen. When Jesus, he was buried in that tomb, amen, we have to be buried by water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of our sins. Amen. So the blood of Jesus Christ will be applied to our life. And when Jesus had rose again from the dead, amen, by the Holy Ghost, amen, so we likewise have to be resurrected. Amen. And that's through receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. Amen. When you receive that power from on high, amen, and you speak in other tongues as the Spirit gives utterance, amen, that's your type of resurrection. Amen. That newness of life, amen. That's when, amen, one is made a new creature in Christ Jesus. Amen. That birth of the Spirit, amen, that Jesus spoke about in John chapter 3. He said, verily I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Amen. So the birth of the water, that's our burial. Amen. Baptism in Jesus' name. The birth of the Spirit, that's our resurrection. Amen. Receiving the gift or the baptism of the Holy Ghost. But repentance, it has to come first. Ain't no way around repentance. Amen. Praise God. So, and that's our part. Amen. We have to willingly die. Amen. To the deeds. Amen. That we're practicing. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The man of God will baptize you in Jesus' name. And God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Amen. And you can, hallelujah. Amen. Be blessed of God. Amen. Be full of joy, peace. Amen. Hallelujah. Rest. Amen. Because Jesus wants to give you rest. Amen. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I give you rest. Amen. In Jesus' name. So we thank the Lord, amen, for this day that he has made. We thank God for, amen, the word, amen, the truth. Because it made me free, amen. It made the other saints of God free, amen. Hallelujah. It'll make you free too. Amen. And we thank God for that fellowship, amen, that we went to this past Friday.
Yes.
Amen. We had a good time with the Lord there. Amen. We really enjoyed the word and everything. Amen. Praise the Lord. And we're looking forward to having a good time. Amen. This upcoming weekend. Amen. In Fort Worth. Amen. With Bishop Lawrence and them. In Jesus' name. So, any questions or comments at this time?
No.
No. Okay. Well. Anybody desire prayer, amen, to the altar.
Thank you for tuning in today's message. If you are in or near the Houston area, you are welcome to come and fellowship with us. Our service address is 4204 Highway 6 North, Houston, Texas, 77084, Sundays at 10 a.m. You may call us at 832-360-5812. Our web address is ahcjc.com. May God bless you and keep you in the name of Jesus Christ.